Hello, in today's Bug Bounty Report Explained, you will learn how it was possible to achieve local remote code execution in PlayStation Now application due to insecure WebSocket server. The vulnerability was reported on Hackerone by Parsia Hackman and he got $15,000 for it. Links to the original report and to his Twitter are in the description. Enjoy! PlayStation Now is a cloud gaming subscription service developed by Sony. It allows streaming games from PS2, 3 and 4 on newer consoles and, most importantly for us, on PCs. It has a desktop application that users open when they want to play a game. The main application is called QAS and it's written in C++. It also runs a local WebSocket server on port 1235. But there is also another application, AGL, and by default, QAS runs it with this URL argument. It's written in Electron, which uses Chromium browser inside. It loads the website from the URL and presents it to the user. I've mentioned that the main application runs the WebSocket server. Let's now explain what it means. With HTTP, it's always the browser sending a request and the server can only send responses. And WebSockets were created to allow browsers to establish asynchronous connection with the server. It means that both sides can send messages wherever they want. However, there are security concerns because HTTP traffic is protected by same origin policy. It's a mechanism that protects websites from different domains from stealing each other's data. But WebSocket connections do not obey same origin policy rules. And the WebSocket connection is initiated by the following JavaScript code. When it gets executed, such HTTP request is being sent. And in the origin header, the browser will put the domain from which this code was executed. And it's the server's responsibility to verify if this origin is trusted or not. If it's valid, the server responds with appropriate response and the WebSocket connection is then established and both sides can communicate. But the PlayStation Now application did not verify the origin. So when a user opened the attacker's website while the PS Now application was running in the background, the attacker could write this JavaScript code and it would allow to establish the connection with the local WebSocket server. It's because this code would be executed in the user's browser, meaning that the localhost refers to his machine. But just establishing a WebSocket connection does not really have an impact. Let's see what we can do with it. Embedding untrusted website inside Electron application can be very harmful, but it's not always the case. It depends on Electron security settings in the application. If you've watched my video about RCE in Microsoft Teams, you know how Electron is built and what node integration security does. If you didn't, I highly recommend watching it. It's available in the card right now, but I will remind those facts anyway here. So Electron application is composed of node main process and the renderer, which is a headless Chromium browser. And when node integration is disabled, there is a separation between the main process and the renderer. It prohibits the website opened in the renderer from accessing Node.js API because it could lead to remote code execution. Without it, the website opened in the renderer can't just import child process and execute code. But the AGL application used node integration equals true setting, which means that the website opened in the renderer can do anything using Node.js API, and this includes importing child process and executing code, which is presented at the moment on the screen. Let's now put this all together and see how the full exploit looked. Normally, messages sent via the WebSocket connection looked like this. We have a comment, its parameters, the application that calls the comment, and the target application. And one of the comments looked particularly interesting for us. It was setURL. It made the target application open the provided website and embed its content to present it to the user. By default, it was some site from PlayStation server. But it was also possible to set this URL to the exploit you've seen seconds ago. So the full exploit would look like this. The attack scenario is that the victim opens this website while PS Now application is running in the background. Those first two lines establish a connection with the local WebSocket server. Then we send a WebSocket message with setURL command, and the parameter is URL that points to our RCE exploit. As the target application, we choose AGL because this is the one that runs with Electron. And when our website is opened, the RCE gets triggered and the attack is successful. The vulnerability was fixed and updated versions of PS Now application are no longer exploitable. The report was triaged as critical and was rewarded $15,000, but the researcher is from Canada, so after taxes he maybe got half of it to his pocket. Anyway, if you've learned something new today, leave a like and leave a subscription. Bye!